Hello and welcome back everybody. Good to see you all again. So in today's video we'll be talking about a small controversial topic on what happened with Titanic's first and second funnel and why they collapsed. So we'll be going over some video illustration and just also some pictures and just also going over some methods on why they collapsed the way they did compared to the third and fourth funnel on the back of the ship. So that being said, let's get into this. So as you can see in this piece of footage right here, is you see the water's already made its way up to the base of the funnel and the support cables. Now eventually, as you will see in this video, the funnel base and the support cables eventually succumb to the water pressure around them and the funnel eventually collapses just like so right here. So back to the point here, is as you can see, the Titanic's funnel was surrounded in water. The funnel and the cables were both surrounded with pretty much a lot of water pressure on them. Now you gotta keep in mind, even though the funnels look sturdy and they look like they're these big, you know, strong towers of steel coming off the roof of the ship, that's quite not the case. The funnels were almost comparable to a tin can with small pipes and a couple small beams inside of them. They weren't as strong as people make them out to be. So, for the first funnel, that's what we're talking about right now, we'll get into what happened in the second funnel in a minute here with another video clip. The first funnel tends to look like it starts to buckle in at the base. Now, you gotta keep in mind, these funnels were riveted down to the ship. There is a plate going all the way around the funnel with rivets holding it down to the ship. Also, the cables would also have helped hold down the funnel and keep it in place. Now, the funnels were at a slant. There should be a picture of slant right there, or one of the slanted funnels on Titanic. So you got to keep in mind, it was already kind of leaning backwards the entire time to help vent smoke away from the ship and behind the ship as the ship kept going on. So there are some theories on, could it have been just due to the angle, or could it have been due to the amount of pressure at the base of the funnel and the wires giving in? Personally, I think it's a bit of both. If you have a freestanding object that's already on an angle, and there's a lot of pressure at the bottom, eventually the pressure will give way. The pressure will make it move unpredictably. So people always wonder why didn't the funnel fall backwards? Because, as I said, when the pressure finally builds up enough that the object that's still freely standing succumbs, it can fall forward, it can fall to the side like the Titanic's funnel did, or it can fall any which direction it really chose to. There is no telling on where it would fall. It just kind of shows it falling. Kind of same thing happened with all the funnels that night. None of them really fell backwards, or from what we can see. There's really no structural damage from a funnel, more from other pressure and just, you know, the ship's superstructure and the entire ship itself just having a structural failure, that being the split. But that being said, we're going to look into the more bit of an interesting story, and that is what happened with the second funnel. This is probably one of the more controversial topics because this one involves something of a bit of a small explosion as the ship was sinking, and there's also a survivor account. So that being said, let's jump into the next one. So as you can see right here, the Titanic is almost underwater, so is the second funnel. And from the account of Jack Thayer, a Titanic survivor, says he claims to have seen a plume and explosion of sparks come out of the second funnel right before it collapsed. So that being said, let's get back into the video and go over some possibilities and some reasons why this funnel may have had this explosion and may have been why it had collapsed. So that being said, get back into it. So as we could see from that clip, we can see that the funnel has a small explosion come out of the funnel right before the funnel collapses. So what we can notice is right after the explosion, the funnel falls into the sea. Now let's go over some science behind this and what probably caused that explosion within the ship. But before we do that, let's just remind ourselves that the funnel was connected to two boiler rooms deep in the bowels of the ship. Every funnel was connected to two boiler rooms. So now into the science part of this. What could have caused the explosion? Everybody's theory, or a lot of people's theory, would be that when the very hot boilers finally came in contact with the ice-cold water, it caused an explosion, which went up the funnel shaft and out of the funnel, jarring rivets loose. Now, do I personally believe it? Yes, I do. I believe that, as most people know who have a little bit of idea of what science is, or have any scientific, you know, experience, You will know that when a hot object touches a very cold object, they tend to explode. Sometimes violently, sometimes not so violent. Just depends on the size, the heat, and the cold. Just depends on, you know, all your factors I just mentioned. So, now on to the question, could it have jarred the rivets loose that were holding the funnel down? I'd say possibly. I wouldn't give it a yes, I wouldn't give it a no. Could it have happened? Yes, but will we really know? Not quite. The only way of telling this would have to be on the ship at the time it sank, because we all know the funnel did eventually fall off, so probably taking all the rivets with it. So obviously there's no way of us now telling could it have blew off rivets or not. So do I think it could have? Yes, but we got to keep in mind another key player right now, and that is the expansion joint on the front of the ship. When I was doing my research on this from a couple sources, I've seen that the expansion joints may have had something to do with it, and I believe it. Now, for those of you who do not know what the expansion joint did, is there were two on the Titanic. What their purpose was to keep the ship flexible during a storm, so the ship could adjust and it wouldn't break apart. I guess they didn't do such a good job the night she sank, as we all know it split up. But what I believe happened is I believe the expansion joint was pulling down the wire, and eventually the wire had enough and gave way. Now, pretty much, we're back to the freestanding object. Now, as we all seen, the water was against the base of the funnel at this time. So pretty much, if the funnel's rivets had blown out, and the water was just lapping at all sides on the funnel, it would eventually have collapsed. So, could the explosion have helped the collapse? Yes. Or could it just been a convenient coincidence? We may never know. I guess that's up for everybody else to, you know, ramble on about. So the reason why we didn't talk about the fourth and third funnel is because we all seen the way they kind of broke up. After the ship went down, or after the ship split up, my apologies, the third funnel instantly just lost stability and collapsed. It fell into the cracked part of the ship. And as you can see from the fourth funnel, it collapsed and fell off the side of the ship. That's pretty simple because the expansion joint on the back was pretty much no longer in use. It was practically useless. So, as you can see, all the cables holding back the third and the fourth funnel pretty much fell when the ship went down, and that's what caused them to collapse. There will be no video about that or anything like that later, and there will probably be no video clip after this about it, just because it's just easy to explain, it's easy to see as well. So that being said, I really do hope all of you like this video. This is one of my first good quality videos I put out with, you know, a mixture of pictures and even video clips with me talking over them. Hopefully you guys liked that. I put a lot of work into it. If you did, you can leave a thumbs up on this video. And if you really did and you're feeling generous today, you can even subscribe. It means a lot to me. And, you know, the more I get likes, the more I get subscribers, it just encourages me to go on. Or just even a little bit of recognition, that's all that really matters to me, you know. As long as I just know that people are still watching and people, you know, appreciate what I do to make these videos, it's all the world, you know. It means the world to me, it means a lot to me. So, you know, feel free to ask any questions about any ships, any ship facts, any pieces of a ship, parts of ships, or anything about ships in general down in the comment section below, and I will answer you to the best of my ability. So that being said, I really, really hope you all enjoyed this video. I plan to make more like this coming up. I'm sorry for the lack of videos in the past 2 weeks. I've been rather busy. But that being said, hope you all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like and possibly subscribe. That being said, I will see you all in the next video. Have a good day.